Welcome to the Addicted to Salsa.com Salsa Dance Lesson Series. My name is Anthony.
And I'm Julie.
And today we're going to teach you another advanced combination, you know, with some nice styling. So, getting started, we come here, open position, and then we're going to do a crossbar lead, basic crossbar lead, going kind of into the outside half a turn, okay? So from here we do 1, 2, 3 with my right, 5, 6, 7, and 1. Now we just end up with our hands crossed, okay? From here, what I want to do, I want to basically create kind of this nice lock effect, kind of bring this hand up, let my left hand go so I can pick it up on the bottom, and then swing the lady's hand so that it flicks and locks again, okay? So we can actually pick it up. Now, one thing with these flicks is that you not only have to remember about flicking this hand or using this hand to actually do the flick, you should also think about using, for example, in this case, the left hand to actually cross it over and make that flick a little bit better for the follower so they know what's actually happening. What may happen sometimes at the club when you're doing this flick or any other flick is some guys will just, you know, think about, okay, I need to flick this hand, I'll just flick it, and then what you realize is that that hand is never going to actually come here to do this cross. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to think of not just flicking this hand, but also kind of doing this scissor effect where you cross both hands. Unlike Ghostbusters, you do want to cross the streams. And from here, that was terrible. Don't even get me started. You want to cross the hands, and then you're ready for the next move. Okay, so if for some reason you dance with a partner who has like a lot of resistance in their hands, you know that if you flick it, they'll like kind of stop it halfway. What you might want to do is then forget about trying to create this nice big circle just to for styling purposes and just come here and just put the hand there and pick it up on the other side. Okay? So, with all that sermon said, here we go. We do 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3. Okay? From here, we're going to teach you the easy version first, which is we're going to continue on a basic step. 5, 6, 7. I'm going to do a crossbar lead with an outside turn, releasing everything into a hammerlock. Okay, so it looks like this. 1, 2, 3. Now, don't worry about my feet. Look at my hands first. As the lady's turning on 5, 6, 7, I am coming, finishing here on this hammerlock position. Okay, so now we will do it from this position. We do this. Oops. Sometimes you forget what flicks happen. Okay, here we go. That's what it was. From here we go. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. And you finish here on 1, basically, right? As you finish here on 1, and you're bringing this hand down, bring it with a little bit extra momentum so that you can let it go on your arm and then pick it up again down here. And that's very important for the next part of the move. Now for ladies, if you're dancing with a guy that does a lot of flicks, or in this case for this pattern, as you're dancing with him, you got him, you know, pay attention to the hands and where he's looking, because where he's looking is going to indicate you what the lead is. Sometimes, you know, you won't get enough of a strong lead as, for example, a hand drop, you know, unless you're actually realizing that he's looking at his hand, so you realize that that's what he's going to be asking for, okay? So always pay attention when you're dancing with guys that do a lot of hand flicks, okay? So from here, we pick this hand up again. We were doing basically 1, 2, 3. As the ladies come forward to do 5, we do kind of like if it was a copa, but I'm going to extend this hand out and then have the lady turn around. So I extend it out and then turn it around so that they're facing back in this direction, okay? So doing it, you know, all together again. From this location, we do 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3. Sorry, this is on 3. We do back on 5, 6, 7, 1, and then just do a free spin. You know, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Okay? So let's try it again from the beginning. Very simple. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, and you're done. Okay, now to do it on 2. Okay, so let's actually start it this way so you guys can see more of the pattern. So here we go. We do 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1. 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1. 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1. 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1. 2, 3, 6, 7. Of course, 6, 7. But you can do whatever you want.